Hey guys, I'm really happy to be back with you. Do you feel a bit annoyed by this too? One thing that really bothers me when soldering is the smoke. It goes straight into your face, makes your eyes sting, and sometimes even makes you cough. Without good ventilation, it gets really uncomfortable. Today I want to show you something I always use to help deal with that annoying soldering smoke. If you found this helpful, don't forget to like the video and subscribe for more DIY tips. Now that you know what we're working with, let's get started on the build. Let's start with this plastic pipe. It's going to be the base for what we're building. The first thing I'm using is this plastic pipe. It's 6 centimeters in diameter, which is a good size for this kind of project. I'm measuring out about 25 centimeters on the pipe and marking the spot so I can cut it. Now I'll go ahead and cut along the mark. I'm going to clamp it in the vise to keep it steady while I cut. After the cut, the next step is to heat it up with a heat gun so the plastic becomes soft and easier to shape. Make sure not to touch the hot surface directly, and it's a good idea to wear gloves to avoid burns. When the pipe is soft, I'll carefully open it up and flatten it out. Then I'll place a piece of wood on top to hold it flat while it cools and hardens. Once the plastic has cooled down and hardened, I'll remove the board. Now it's nice and flat and ready to work with the sheet ready. The next step is to measure and cut it into the rectangular pieces I need for the build. With everything measured and marked, I'll now carefully cut along the lines to get the pieces I need. On this large square piece, I'm going to mark the center point and cut out a circle right in the middle. I'm taking a plastic bottle and cutting off the top section. Once I've got the bottle top cut, I'll glue it right onto the center of the square plastic sheet. I'm reusing an old cooling fan from an old PC. Still works fine for what I need. All right, check this out. Here's how it works. The way this fan works is pretty simple. It pulls air in from one side and pushes it out from the other. That airflow creates a continuous cycle, which is perfect for things like cooling, ventilation, or even pulling smoke away when you're soldering. Now I'm fixing the four plastic panels onto the fan. These will help support and stabilize the structure. To attach these four plastic pieces to the cooling fan, I'm going to use hot glue. It's quick and strong enough for this kind of lightweight setup. I'll apply a generous amount of glue along the edge of each piece, then press it firmly onto the fan. Just hold it in place for a few seconds until the glue sets. Next, I'm going to fix this plastic sheet onto the assembly. I'll apply hot glue around the edge of the bottle's top and press it firmly onto the plastic sheet to secure it. Next, I'm just drilling a hole right in the middle of the cap. I'm screwing the eye screw into the top of the cap to make a simple hanging point. This will act as a simple hanging point, so later on I can easily hang the whole unit in place, whether it's on a wall, under a shelf, or wherever I need it. Next up, I'm adding a power switch and a battery connector, so I can easily turn the fan on and off. Now I'll start wiring everything up. First, I connect one wire from the battery connector to one terminal on the switch. Then, from the other terminal of the switch, I run a wire to the positive lead of the fan. To make the connections more secure, I'll solder the wires at each joint. After that, I'll slide on some heat shrink tubing and shrink it with a heat gun. That way everything's neat, insulated, and safe. Always double check your polarity before connecting power. Now I'm going to attach the battery and the switch onto the fan using hot glue. I just apply a generous amount of glue to the back of the battery holder and press it onto the side of the fan. Then I do the same with the switch. Position it where it's easy to reach and secure it firmly in place. Make sure everything sticks well before moving on. This fan runs perfectly on a 9V battery, which makes it a simple and portable solution for solder fume extraction. I'm using a plastic tube and adding some tape to the end to make a tighter seal when it's inserted into the bottle top. The tape helps it fit tightly and prevents any air leaks. This tube will guide the smoke into the fan, so make sure it's snug and secure. Now let's test it out. I'll do a bit of soldering near the intake tube to see how well it works. As soon as the smoke comes out, you can see it getting pulled straight into the tube and away from my face. It's not super powerful, but it definitely helps reduce the amount of smoke around the workspace.
こう思うので、
まあね、
so that's it for today's DIY smoke extractor. It's super simple, made from stuff I already had at home, but it really helps when I'm soldering. Keeps the smoke away from my face and makes the whole process more comfortable. If you often do small soldering projects like I do, I definitely recommend trying something like this. If you enjoyed this project, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more simple DIY builds like this. I've got more cool ideas coming up, so stay tuned. And if you have any suggestions or questions, drop them in the comment below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.